Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to sketch polar curves. And the polar curve that we're going to be sketching today is r equals 1 plus cosine of theta. So the way that I like to sketch polar curves is to first draw them on a rectangular or a Cartesian graph, the kind of graph that we're normally used to, an x-y axis. We're going to graph it there first, and then based on what we find, we're going to translate it to a polar graph. So that's going to involve a couple steps. The first thing that I do is take what's inside our trigonometric identity here. So in our case, the trigonometric identity is cosine, the cosine function. I'm going to take what's inside, in our case, pi, and set that, theta, and set that equal to pi over 2. So set theta equal to pi over 2. And what I want to do is solve for theta. Sometimes inside of your trigonometric function, you might have, for example, 2 theta is really common. If you have 2 theta and you set that equal to pi over 2 and you solve for theta, you'll end up with theta equals pi over 4, right? In our case, we want to solve for theta. We've already done that because we just have theta inside the trigonometric function. So we leave theta equals pi over 2 as it is. I always set it equal to pi over 2 no matter what's inside the trigonometric function. And that usually makes it easiest to sketch the graph on a Cartesian coordinate system, remember with the xy axes, and then translate it onto the polar graph. So now I'm going to take pi over 2. Once I've solved for theta, I'm going to take whatever I get, so in this case pi over 2, and I'm going to mark off my x-axis in increments of pi over 2. So here's what that looks like. Ignore the graph for 1 second, and we're just going to look at the increments at which we mark off our x-axis. So you always start at 0, which is right along the y-axis here, so 0, and then I'm just going to add pi over 2 each time, because that's what I got when I solved for theta. So pi over 2, and then when you add pi over 2 to pi over 2, you just get pi. Add another pi over 2, you'll get 3 pi over 2, 2 pi, 5 pi over 2, 3 pi, and so on. And you could keep going. And I like to give myself at least, like, you know, 6 to 8 increments along the x-axis and graph the curve on the rectangular coordinate system at least that far. So I've got plenty to work with when I go to translate it onto the polar graph. So mark off your x-axis in increments of whatever you got when you solved for theta. So do that first, and then what we're going to do is we are going to plug each one of these values, 0, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, etc., into our original function, r equals 1 plus cosine theta. We're going to plug those values in for theta, and we're going to solve for r. Keep in mind that we're kind of treating these values here as x instead of theta, and we're going to solve for y values instead of r. When we move on to the polar coordinate system, it's going to be r and theta, but right now we're working with an xy axis. So let's go ahead and do the first one. We'll plug in 0, which is our x coordinate right here, for theta, and we're going to be solving for r, or in other words, y, because we're on a rectangular coordinate system. So when we plug in 0, remember that you can, to find cosine of 0 or any of these values, you can either use the unit circle, or if you have a calculator that will calculate this for you, you can do that as well. So cosine of 0 is going to be 1, so we'll end up with 1 plus 1, which gives us 2. We will then plug in pi over 2 for theta into our original function. Cosine of pi over 2 is 0, so we end up with 1 plus 0, which is just 1. And we continue to do this. Cosine of pi is negative 1. 1 plus negative 1 gives us 0. Cosine of 3 pi over 2 is 0. 1 plus 0 is 1, etc. And we'll keep going, plugging in each of our values, 2 pi, 5 pi over 2, and 3 pi, into our original function, solving for r. Now you can see we have this set of values here, which are going to be our r coordinates on our polar coordinate system. They're going to be the y coordinate on our rectangular system that we have going right now. So you can see we have 2, 1, 0, 1, 2, 1, 0. And now we're going to plot these as our y coordinates on our rectangular graph. So at 0, we found that y was equal to 2. So at 0, y is going to be equal to 2, so we plot this point here. At pi over 2, y is equal to 1. So pi over 2 here, we graph the point 1 right here. At pi, y is equal to 0. So we find pi here, and y is equal to 0, so we plot this point here. And if we keep going, we'll see that at 3 pi over 2, y is equal to 1. At 2 pi, y is equal to 2. At 5 pi, y is equal to 1. And at 3 pi, y is equal to 0. So we would plot each of those points, and then we're going to join them. And when we join them, we'll get this nice smooth arc that you see here. And what I've done is drawn them in different colors so that we'll easily be able to translate the segments that we see here onto the polar coordinate system. So we've got purple, orange, blue, green, and then you can see that they repeat purple, orange, and we would have blue, green, purple, orange, blue, green if we kept going, and it would go on to infinity as we move out to the right on the x-axis. But this will give us enough information that we'll need for to use for our polar graph. So we would plot each of those points and then we connect them, just draw a nice smooth arc. Now we're going to take this information and we're going to translate it onto the polar system, and here's what that's going to look like. So we were talking in terms of xy coordinates. Now we're going to move into theta r. So theta is our angle, r is our radius. So in terms of plotting points on a polar graph, the first thing you're going to look at is the angle. Remember that the angle 0 is along the x-axis here. And then if you move counterclockwise, the angle slowly increases. So up here, once we get to the y-axis, the angle is pi over 2. When we get back down to the x-axis, moving counterclockwise, the angle is pi. Down to the y-axis here is the angle 3 pi over 2. And back to the x-axis is the angle 2 pi, just like the unit circle. So angle right goes around like this. So that's theta. And then r is going to be the radius, or in other words, the distance from the origin. So our first point, right, we ended up with 0, 2, right? We plugged in 0 for theta and we got 2 for r. So at the angle 0 along the x-axis, we're going to move out a distance of 2, right? The angle is 0, the radius is 2. So at the angle 0 along the x-axis, the radius is 2, and you can see we're out here at 2. So our first point we plot right here. Now, if we look back at our graph here, we can see at pi over 2, the radius is going to be 1, right? At this point, y is 1, so our radius on our polar graph is 1. So we're going to go up an angle pi over 2 and plot the point at a radius or a distance of 1 from the origin. So we're going to move from the angle 0 and radius 2 up to the angle pi over 2 and out a distance of 1. So right along the y-axis here is the angle pi over 2, and we're going to be out a distance of 1, which is the point right here. So as we move up toward pi over 2, we curl in halfway, not straight out to 2, but right out there to a distance of 1. So this is going to be right there, that pi over 2, 1. Now, that's in purple. Now here, if we look back at our rectangular graph, as we move from pi over 2 to pi over 2 being the angle along the y-axis here, and pi being the angle along the x-axis here, so we're moving from along the y-axis to along the x-axis. As we move that 90 degrees right there, that angle, we're going to go from a radius of 1 to a radius of 0. So when we get all the way down to this angle here along the x-axis, we're actually going to end up curling back into the origin because we're at a radius of 0, which means we end up back at the origin. So we're at a radius of 1 and we curl back in to a radius of 0 as we approach this angle of pi. Now, when we move from pi to 3 pi over 2, we're moving from the angle here along the x-axis right here to the angle along the y-axis here. So we're going this 90 degrees right here. And as we do that, we're starting from the origin, a radius of 0, and we're moving out to a radius of 1. You can see here the value is 1 at 3 pi over 2. So we're moving from this angle at a radius of 0, moving toward the angle 3 pi over 2, out to a radius of 1, so we end up right here. And then moving from 3 pi over 2 to 2 pi is moving this last 90 degrees right here, from 3 pi over 2 along the y-axis to 2 pi along the x-axis. And we're moving from a radius of 1 to 2. You can see here 1 and then all the way up to 2. So we're going to move from the point where we were here, 1, and then all the way out to 2, which is right back where we started. And if we continued, we'd end up following the same graph. Notice that here on the rectangular graph, we end up with the same purple segment. From 2 pi to 5 pi over 2 is going to be an identical distance as from 0 to pi over 2. So we would just retrace our steps along this graph, and we would keep going. So we finished our polar graph. And notice here, I've put in the angles. So this is this purple segment here goes from the angle 0 to the angle pi over 2, which you see right here. The orange part of the graph goes from pi over 2 to pi. We have pi over 2 right here to pi. The blue part goes from pi to 3 pi over 2. That's from pi to 3 pi over 2, the blue part, and then the green part is 3 pi over 2 to 2 pi. And then we repeat purple again. So 3 pi over 2 to 2 pi, and then we're repeating purple again. So that's how we draw the polar graph, just one segment at a time, putting it first on our rectangular coordinate system, and then translating these xy coordinates into theta r coordinates. So anyway, I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.